Hello everyone, this is Professor He. Nice to see you again. The topic of this task is about the absorption refrigeration systems. Another form of refrigeration that becomes economically attractive when there is a source of inexpensive thermal energy at a temperature of 100 to 200 degrees centigrade is absorption refrigeration. Some examples of inexpensive thermal energy sources include geothermal energy, solar energy, and waste heat from cogeneration or process steam plants, and even natural gas when it is available at a relatively low price. As the name implies, absorption refrigeration systems involve the absorption of a refrigerant by a transport medium. The most widely used absorption refrigeration system is the ammonia water system, where ammonia serves as the refrigerant and water as the transport medium. The ammonia water refrigeration machine is shown in the figure. Other absorption refrigeration systems include water lithium bromide and water lithium chloride systems, where water serves as the refrigerant. The latter two systems are limited to applications such as air conditioning, where the minimum temperature is above the frozen point of water. Compared with vapor compression systems, ARS have one major advantage. A liquid is compressed instead of a vapor, and as a result, the work input is very small and often neglected in the cycle analysis. The steady flow work is proportional to the specific volume, and thus the work input for absorption refrigeration systems is very small and often neglected in the cycle analysis. The operation of these systems is based on heat transfer from an external source. Therefore, absorption refrigeration systems are often classified as heat-driven systems. The absorption refrigeration systems are much more expensive than the vapor compression refrigeration systems. They are more complex and occupy more space. They are much less efficient, thus requiring much larger cooling towers to reject the waste heat, and they are more difficult to survive since they are less common. Therefore, absorption refrigeration systems should be considered only when the unit cost of thermal energy is null and is projected to remain null relative to electricity. Absorption refrigeration systems are primarily used in large commercial and industrial installations. The COP of absorption refrigeration systems is defined as the COP of actual absorption refrigeration systems is usually less than 1. Air conditioning systems based on absorption refrigeration, called absorption chillers, perform best when the heat source can supply heat at a high temperature with little temperature drop. The maximum COP of an absorption refrigeration system is determined by assuming that the entire cycle is totally reversible. The refrigeration system would be reversible if the heat from the source were transferred to a colored heat engine and the work output of this heat engine is supplied to a colored refrigerator to remove heat from the refrigerated space. For refrigerator, we have then the overall COP of an absorption refrigeration system under reversible conditions as shown in the figure becomes. Okay, that's all for this task. Thank you very much and see you next time.